Happy Tuesday. Last week, many subscribers asked, what is the best ammo for my slingshot? So today we're on our way to field test of two of different types of ammo and determine what is the perfect ammo to use. Last week, we saw how to use our slingshot, but we didn't talk about what type of ammo to use. There are basically two types of ammo, steel and glass. There is another category, but we'll call that the environmentally friendly ammo, and we'll leave that for another time in another video. Many claim that glass marbles are the best and most inexpensive type of ammo to use, ranging from pillunking to hunting and competition, while others claim that steel ball bearings do the same job and are equally impressive. There are pros and cons to both, so today, with the help of my lovely wife, Miss April, we will shoot the stuff out of... So hi, babe, are you excited for today's video?
Oh yeah, absolutely excited.
So what do you think the outcome is going to be? Do you think the marbles are going to be the cat's meow, or will ball bearings prove to be the king of ammo?
I say the ball bearings.
We will set the up targets at 30 feet downrange, as this seems to be the average agreed upon distance for both glass and steel for both pillunking, hunting, and competition. The targets are standard targets, aluminum cans, water bottles, and ping pong balls. We'll hit the target three times and examine the impact. There are other considerations that is said to be factors, so we will include them as well. The length of the draw, how far you can pull it back. The type of bands used, flat or tubes, over the top or through the fork. Over the top is said to cause the ammo to curve, while through the fork says it doesn't. Oh, and there is some science to all this, such as weight, trajectories, speed and mass of the ammo, but that's all really boring stuff, so let's put all that into the description below, so if you want to look at it, you can. I'm not discounting that those variables come into play, but if they do, that's a very small amount. I believe that this is a gray line between preference and fact. So let's get started.
A little low on that.
Oh, water bottle. Corner.
All right, so looking at this, we've got three hits 30 feet away. That's with the half inch marbles.
Nope, no likey. No likey at all.
Don't like it at all, huh?
No, and I'm putting it, I mean, it was twisted, but I'm putting it.
Ooh. Oh.
And I got my neck.
Oh.
And my arm.
God, look at this. I got hand slap. Oh, with the ball. And it.
Looks pretty cool and everything. It's a dinky little thing, dead handy to use. But ow, I got smacked with the band here on my hand and here on my neck. Don't shoot worse crap. On the regular sling.
I Okay, with the marble, I have more accuracy. You can see the three, one here, here, and here, and it actually penetrated better than the half-inch daisy.
Do a ball and see how that works.
Well, there you have it. It appears that the only real difference is the size of the ammo. Smaller ammo tends to not hit as hard, and the larger ammo kills it every time. The paintballs are the funnest to use, and you can see the impact right away. Let us know in the comments below what was your thoughts on the ammo and what was your favorite part of this video. Please like and share this video with a friend and also subscribe to this channel. Since you're already there, go ahead and click that bell icon so that you get notified of any updates. And if you have any video suggestions, leave them in the comments below. I'm Berlon Birch. I'll see you next time.